Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning, my dear friends in Christ. We begin this Sunday reflection in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today is the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time, Year B. We thank God for the gift of life. Thank you, Jesus. Our reading today is from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 9, from verse 38 to 43 and 45. And the topic is a question. Are you for Christ or against him? Are you for Christ or against him? One of the disciples of our Lord Jesus Christ asked him if they should stop a man who was casting out demons using the name of Jesus. Yet, the man does not belong to their group or as disciples. The answer of our master is that anyone who is not against the Christ is for Christ. You either belong to Christ in word and deed, or you show that you are against him by the things you say or do. Hear me again. You either belong to Christ in word and deed, or you show that you are against him by the things you say and by the things you do. So I ask you again, are you for Christ or against him? The man that the disciples saw was genuinely casting out demons and doing good works in the name of Christ. That means the man is a believer, even though he was not in the group of the disciples who were with Jesus Christ. There are many Christians all over the world today using the name of Christ and working for him that we do not know. Yes, there are many Christians today who work for Christ, yet many people do not know them. The fact that somebody is not a member of your parish, a member of your society, does not mean that the person is not a Christian. The fact that the person does not belong to your group does not mean that the person is not a Christian. We can know who is for Christ by what the person does, how he does it, and the aim of doing it. The only way we can know for somebody who is for Christ is by the way the person behaves, the way he does these things, the aim of doing it. Are we doing good things in the name of Christ and for his glory? This is a question again the Lord is asking you that is hearing this message. Are you doing good things in the name of Jesus Christ and to the glory of God? Are you reaching out to people in your own small corners in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, even when other believers may not notice you? Are you on the Lord's side or are you against him? Our Lord Jesus Christ said that by their fruit you shall know them. If you say you are for Christ, your fruits and actions must show for it. And if you are against Christ, we will also know by your words and activities. Yes, your words, your activities will showcase where you belong. If you belong for Christ, we shall know. If you are against Christ, it will show by your activities, by the way you do things, by the words that comes out of your mouth. May God grant us help to stay on the side of Christ at all times, and to do things that will show that we are for him and not against him, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Child of God, I pray that you will be on the side of Christ. I pray that you will be on his side, on the Lord's side. May God give us the grace to help us to be on his side in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You that have heard this message, try and be on the Lord's side. Try and know what you do, how you do it, and the aim of doing it. May God help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Happy Sunday and have a fruitful week ahead. You are highly blessed. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.